rip your mirror, shake like a straw. Car so big, of course. I'm
falling. Yo, everybody, everybody, what's up, what's up? Yo, of course. Yo, everything which can go wrong just did go wrong. I swear to God. And now the phone just dropped. No lie. The mic was cut. The cam wasn't working. I had to replug in the Irix stream. Beautiful, beautiful start in the Nelson Scratch Show. Let's ride, we together. Hope you guys are good. Yeah, hope you're doing well. Today, yeah, I was at the dentist, so I'm not really, you know, the teeth always. The dentist, you know, who likes a dentist? You know, I hate that shit. So it might be a little dizzy. I don't know. Maybe. Yo, it's a free ride. It's a free ride, Chili. Puma Baby, what's up? Chili. DJ M Kurt, good to see you guys. And when she call my pin now, I won't even pick up. Started from the trap, now I rap. Started from the trap, now I rap. Riding today, we riding through New York City, from Flushing Main Street to Hudson Yards, 34th Street. And it's gonna be some tracks, some scratching, you know, whatever. It's gonna be what we create right now. Bitch, I'm from Calipina. Chili, you need the rider's free. Look around, they took my style like, motherfucker, you trippin'. We trippin'. The rider's free, but take your card, you know. Metro Nels. Yo, Metro Nels. Metro Nels, that's good. That's good, I like that. Shout out to Chili, by the way, who always have great ideas. Always add something to the show, you know. I appreciate you for that. You know, when if the show is an outlet for anything, you know, for you, then I'm really happy, you know, because that's why I'm here, you know, that's why I'm doing that also. And also very egoistically for me, it's also an outlet, you know, so I can be in a different mood like just seconds before, and then I start communicating with you guys and try to read the comments and try to just be present in the moment, you know. And then my whole mood shifts, you know, so I hope it's the same for you. And let's cut it up, you know, let's cut it up, let's ride, enjoy the ride. I don't know, take something to eat, something to drink, you know, and enjoy, you know, enjoy. Let me know which station is your favorite station. Maybe if you came already here to New York, so you might know some stations, so yeah, let's interact and let that be the outlet for our crazy, you know. The show started crazy, by the way. It started crazy. You know, like everything which can go wrong, like I said, did go wrong, you know. So that's also a great lesson to always to adapt and to be quick, you know. Like you have to adapt in the situation or you just, you know, like, or you just fail, you know. And failing is not really an option for us here, you know. So we push through. And thanks to you guys, thanks to your energy also, you know, like, that gives the energy also to continue here and doing what I'm doing, you know. So thanks for that. Thanks for your time. Let's go. scratching on the collectible looper number 5. I have to I've mentioned that more often, I feel, you know, because I get on YouTube or whatever when there's some new posts on Instagram or Facebook, people ask me, oh, what's that beat? Which looper was that, you know? And sometimes on 2 hours is like, you don't even remember this beat, that beat or whatever, you know? Or sometimes I do, sometimes I do not, you know? Sometimes it's complete freestyle and I just dig through some loopers. It's been a while I wasn't digging through. And then there is some loopers where I have like my favorite beats or whatever, you know? Shout out to DJ Twiddle, who asked that question on Facebook, and I still have to re-watch the show and then find the beats again to tell you what looper that was, but we're doing that extra work here at Nelson Scratch TV. Thanks MCut for the fire, DJ Puma baby, what's up? Your set was super dope last Sunday. I'm definitely gonna tune in next Sunday, and yeah, chili, what's up? My baby, it's Angel Goofy Nels. Angel Goofy Nels. I take that as a compliment. You mean mental health crazy? Like, you know, sometimes, you know, I think we all are not far from crazy, you know. What is normal? You know, what is normal? How you guys doing? What's up with you? What you up to right now? What time is it in Germany? Like 1? 1:30, something like that. 1:22 exactly.
Come like a guillotine. Come like a guillotine.
You guys appreciate the ride. What's going on? You guys are good. We appreciate the cuts with the view. Wow, already in the city. That was a fast ride.
Cut like a guillotine.
Yamsha, funky funky ah, Yamsha, funky funky ah. How you doing Yamsha, comment ça va? La France est dans la place, DJ M-Cut, DJ Yamsha. DJ Puma baby, New York City, New Jersey is in the house, Chile, Germany, what's up? Chile is chilling right now. Yeah, I know, that was lame, it was a bad joke. Closer to the mic. Gelato in your vape. I feel you on that. So you see, he is this lemon cherry. Lemon cherry is the real deal.
Yeah. do you.
So, whatever helps relaxing sometimes, you know, in this world, sometimes it's good to find some ways here to meditate, to relax, and you know, whatever helps you to go there, you know. Yeah, I understand, because you're in Germany, you still cannot say that, you know. It's like, by the way, you don't even have some real weed in Germany, right? It's only CBD. I never heard of real weed in Germany. I might tell some bullshit, I don't know. So, definitely the gelato, go for it. Fucking with that gumbo also lately. Now in the US for a while, and like seeing that it's illegal here to, you know, to drink in the streets, and I know Germany well. Yo, Kram, what's up? Neuf Trois is in the building, and like, you know, you can drink like alcohol in the streets in Germany, you know, and I feel there's much more fights under alcohol. It's not even I feel, that's my personal experience, you know, as a nightlifer, you know, like DJ of course, and like being around so many people, fights and aggressivity often happens like more under completely drunk people than completely stoned out people or spliff people or whatever, you know. So it is what it is, you know. Weed makes you think by yourself. I don't say that you can only think by yourself with weed, right? That's not what I'm saying. But weed can bring you somewhere where sometimes when we're in the daily rush, you know, we forget to relax, you know. But it can be also very harmful for some people, you know. So it's not that I'm promoting it or whatever, you know, it's just like my personal experience with it, you know. Frankfurt is listening, yo, shout out. Rip Berger Andre, oh, okay. Might be a homie of you, so rest in peace to the homie. Frankfurt is in the house. I remember I played in Frankfurt, I opened for C2C in the... Now the name is not common, but it was like on the main street venue, and yeah, it was super dope in Frankfurt with C2C at the the name. I don't remember the name of the venue. What was it? Adlib? No. It was kind of like a theater. You know, it's on the main street, it's a big kind of theater, but also like a concert venue, you know. Cookies? Nah, now you're talking weed. Now I'm talking venue. So, no, it was not Cookies, also something with the O, I feel, you know, but I might be wrong. It was in 2013, yeah, 2013. So yeah, shout out to Frankfurt, definitely, shout out to Germany, shout out to New Jersey, shout out to France, Paris is in the house. Yeah, see you soon, Rick. Back, Andre. Product from the dentist helps, you know? It definitely helps. We in another space today. DJ M. Kurt, appreciate you. Thank you, my brother. Kram, Kram, Yamsha, M. Kurt. Thank you. thank you, appreciate you guys. DJ Puma Baby, Frankfurt homie, shout out to you. What is that? Appreciate you, thanks for that. I love to, you know, bring just the vibe to you guys, you know, cutting it up, getting warm, you know, finding the dopest beats, you know. But getting tired, I really don't know what you're talking about right now.
We don't give a fuck. trash.
Yo, Cultura Lima, what's up? What's up? Good to see you. Shoutouts going out to Brazil. Yo, you see, I just told you in the beginning I come back from the dentist. I'm not in the best mood right now, you know. I cannot even talk correctly, but you know, I never could. So, and you see, 1 hour later, you know, already hyped as fuck, you know, the music, your energy, guys, you know, so appreciate these moments with you. Nelson Scratch TV, that's what we're doing Tuesdays and Saturdays. Tune in, you know. Just having fun here. Oh, so yeah, Ripback Andre. See you next time then, alright? Thanks for connecting and yeah, it's a pleasure to have you here. Cultura Lima. You have teeth pain also, yeah, that's fucked up, you know, like, I think it's very cliche to say I hate the dentist or some shit like that, but it's not even I hate or whatever, but it's my least favorite, one of my least favorite things, let's say it like this, you know, it's not like on the top of the, yeah, to do this, but then I'm glad when I can do it, you know, especially in the US, what? Let's avoid the subject. How is it in Brazil? Is it easy to find, like, I don't even want to say a cheap dentist, you know, but to find a, like, a regular dentist? Or do you have also to sell the mortgage on your house or whatever, or take a credit at the bank to get one tooth replaced? So often, right? Hey guys, what's up? What's up? Good? Yes, that was dope. Yeah, you know, I always tell myself, like, I'm in a country where I can do it, you know, or but it's totally crazy here in the US, you know, so other countries don't even have, like, not this kind of advanced dentist and everything, you know, but yeah, it is what it is. Nobody likes to have to sell the turntables, everything, you know, to pay the teeth, you know? Have to sell what you have to sell your car, your apartment, your house, just to get the, like, two teeth fixed, you know? What the fuck? Yeah, but like Stream Element says, have fun, enjoy your life, don't forget to breathe. Yeah, the mic? You don't know. The mic is maybe one teeth, you know? No, I like to laugh when it's sad sometimes, you know? Like, either you laugh or you cry about shit like that, you know? But now I laugh with you guys, you know, when the camera is on. But by myself, I cried about it. Like, oh shit, I have to give the mic away, you know? Oh shit, I tell you. We on this looper, the collectible 9 from Odilon. We was on the collectible 5 before, So yeah, like I said before, just have to give a little bit more precision about where the beat's coming from, so you guys can find these loopers and cut it up also, you know, like that's what I want also, that you get these free loopers. You have to find like a website where they still downloadable, you know, there's a lot of loopers for free out there. And shout out to DJ Odilon from Belgium, DJ Odilon, who is like, you know, he is one of the bosses in this game, you know, like let's give him credit, you know, he's one of the looper king boss, who make like the dopest loopers out there, you know. So you can get these loopers, and you can even hit like DJ Odilon looper on YouTube by for example, or like on the Scratch Nerds page. You're gonna also find like a lot of beats and, you know, whatever, like scratch competitions also. So yeah, give a look to DJ Odilon. And yeah, it was a question on Facebook where DJ Twiddle, shout out to DJ Twiddle, he asked, yo, at the minute number 7 from this show, what was the looper? You know, I'm like, yo, I have to give you a little bit more precision about the music also. Mad Villain, what's up? Kram, what's up? Mad Villain, good to see you back. Good to see you, good to see you. We here, you know. Coming from the dentist, but yeah, the mouth getting a little bit better. Pause. Yeah, you know, there's always this coming from the dentist feeling. The energy was a little bit low at the beginning, and now the energy is at a complete different level, you know, like, which I always bring back to hip-hop and turntables. You know, for me, scratching is my outlet too, you know, so definitely the music shifts my energy, you know. I don't know how it is for you, and now I'm gonna shut up and scratch a little bit more than talk. What do you guys think about that?
do some dope shit. Do some dope shit.
With you on that, Cultura Lima, like the beat could be like, yeah, something in the movie. What kind of movie? In what kind of movie do you see this beat? Like definitely in a like a scene where everybody get together and like try to conquer something and march, you know, like on this beat. I don't know, like that's what I see right now. What do you guys see on this beat? Like what kind of scene or which movie?
TV.
Yeah, plodding on the big coup, you know, like, and yeah, that's a good idea too. Traveling through New York like that, you fuck with the concept. Yo, I even have a ride from the West Coast to New York, but this shit was too long. From down south to New York. Whatever.
Bye.
Shots in the air. C'est ça qui se passe. Fictive gunshots, you know, like just for the energy, right? Yes! Stank face, exactly. That's my face today. Eisenmann in the house. Kultur Ralema also in the place to be. In the place to be. I just understood that more deeply right now. I know you might laugh, but I didn't speak English all my life. No. In the place to be. That's exactly what we are right now. Nelson Scratch TV, in the place to be. Woo! Nah, I was overhyping right now. I was overhyping that shit. It was not the craziest punchline. Yo, you know what? Just thinking about punchline. That's how my brain works, you know, I say some words and then I just remind myself something which I, you know, sometimes we don't even see some shit, like, there's so much information right now that sometimes I'm a little bit cut also from too much social media, you know, like, I have to balance the shit to stay focused, right, and this morning, I don't know how, click, just want to see what time is it. I don't know, I'm on YouTube already, like, and click from one video to another, and then I see another video where the guy say, yeah, Pat Stay from the battle rap scene passed away, you know, and just by making this stupid rhyme just before, you know, Nelson Scratch TV in the place to be, that brought up, like, these crazy rhymers, you know, like, I love a cappella rap, you know, and like KOTD, you know, was the first shit I saw, and then like I discovered also the whole old school shit, the URL, and like now it's not old school, but I think they started a little bit earlier too, and you know, love all this since years, the whole battle rap scene, you know, and just this morning, without even, you know, being really awake, I see like that Pat Stay passed away, you know, he was stabbed in the club, in I don't know where, you know, like I was like, what the fuck, like is that like a joke or, you know, then you know, you click, then you have your infos, sometimes too much infos also, it's not very good, I hate waking up like this, but it's my fault, it's totally on me, you know, nobody asked me to watch that shit, or to be that early on internet already, like out in the world, usually I like to, there's no usually, but sometimes I like to take time off and time for myself, you know, and first wake up and, you know, start your day before you get too much infos in your face, you know, that can also guide your day in this direction or another. So yeah, all that to say that that's pretty sad news and unexpected also, you know. Pat Stay, like, I don't know, was really one of the last name, but yeah, let me finish my sentence, was really one of the last names I expected to pass away, you know, like that fast. I feel like that he definitely was one of the best, you know, like Pat Stay was one of the best battle rappers. His, like, all the battles I watched, you know, like against whoever it was, you know, like the one against Disaster, of course, or the one against so many names, you know, like I think he battled like everybody, you know, like he battled everybody. And like, I was not a super fan of his persona. I don't know, something was a little bit too licked, too clean for me, you know. But he always came as the, not the punisher, but he says some real shit, you know, like some really real shit, and which makes you just like him, you know, even if maybe his, the energy he gives to you at first, I was not connecting with it right away. I think that's what I want to say. I was like, nah, like somebody like Disaster, for example, you know, I don't know, I like the kind of aggressiveness also, like he have like this crazy aggressiveness, and so he just like punched me in my face, you know, when I saw the battle Disaster versus Cannabis, you know. But Pat Stay was always like, okay, he was good. Okay, he was good. Like, I didn't give it up to him right away, right? Like, he needed a few battles that I see, nah, this guy is really good, you know? And that's, I don't know, taste, you know, music, taste, what you like. You know, like, I really feel that sometimes some things you need to listen a little bit more deeper to it, you know, to understand it. And some things hit you right away, and then maybe you say, I maybe jumped a little bit too fast on the bandwagon, or I don't know if you can say that, but yeah, like on the hype, you know, on the hype of a persona. Sometimes I like to not jump on the hype right away when everybody is on the hype of this TV show, of this artist, of this painting, whatever, you know. Like, I'm always a little bit afraid of going too much with the hype, you know, and not having time to digest and having my own opinion on this book, this album, this movie, you know, whatever it is. And so sometimes I figured out that I need to buy a record and then to let play the C side and the D side, and then, oh shit, I don't have time to put the A and B side back. So I just reflip the vinyl. And then, like, the song number 3, I didn't even really fuck with, like, in the beginning, even the song was annoying me. Then suddenly I love it, you know, it's that song I really like on the album, weirdly, you know. I don't know how it is for you guys, you know, how it might be everybody have his own way of coming, of connecting with art, I feel. Today, like around 2 hours, something like that. The streams are always like around 2 hours, maybe a little bit more. Cultura Lima will offer you an adventure holiday. Yeah, yo, if he invites you to Brazil, you have to go. Definitely, you have to go. Yeah, coming back to what I was saying, like, it's really, yeah, it's saddening to hear like somebody you even didn't maybe fuck with at the beginning, but then he win your opinion, he wins you as a hip hop fan. You say this guy is dope, you know, he just knows what he's doing, you know, and he tried a lot of things on stage Pat's Day, you know, he came dressed different, he had a little beard like this, then a full beard, then I don't know, some chain, some, you know, like then he had the bandana, then he come with the full flower suit with like a big head, you know, like he did a lot of shit, you know. So I like these guys too, you know, which nobody really likes in the beginning because maybe they're a little bit too truthful, or they too blunt, raw or something like that, you know, maybe not raw. And wow, the raw in the mic was just raw right now for your ears, I'm sorry for that. But definitely, yeah, I like these guys which have first to win me over, you know, like to their art, to what they're doing, you know. Drake is a great example for that too, you know. Like at the beginning I was hating, I was hating strong, you know, like nah, this is not for me, it's more like for, you know, for the woman, you know, it is what it is. At the beginning it was a little bit too singing and smooth to me, and then there was this song like with Eminem, Lil Wayne and Travis Barker who hit the drums on that, and then I was like, ooh, okay, that sounds not bad, you know. And then came, I still didn't give 100% credit, right? And then came like started from the bottom, now we're here. I was like, nah, okay, this guy, even I'm not like a big fan of the whole thing, but this guy knows what he's doing, you know. And then he came like with the album, When You Read This It's Too Late, and then I was like, okay, I'm a fan, you know, it's okay, you got me in your corner, you know. It's like, nah, that shit is real, like, oh, okay, maybe it's me who didn't understand something, you know. So I always, all this, you know, all this long talking to explain that sometimes I like to be surprised also by an artist, and like maybe at the beginning like a little bit b-boy stands, you know, like nah, okay, show me what you got, you know. And then the person shows me and I say, this person is dope, you know. Not be afraid also of that, you know, of being wrong sometimes. Same thing, and I'm gonna finish with that story, you know, is Action Bronson, you know. Is like at the beginning I was not convinced because I didn't know, I knew so less, and I heard more people in my ear like, oh yeah, this name. So I'm always a little bit, like I said, afraid of the hype, you know. Sometimes the hype is real, sometimes the hype is good, but overhyping everything, you know, like sometimes I like to take a step back and say, do I really fuck with that, or is it just because everybody else, yeah, this is dope, right? So Action Bronson, like my homie Rec Tape, you know, shout out to Rec Tape, big shout out to him, because he gave me like, he talked about him, and I said, nah, if I wanna, yo, I was hard on Action Bronson, I said, if I wanna listen to Ghostface, I listen to Ghostface. Wow, you see, I clicked like very fast, and then I heard like the Ghostface flow a little bit, you know, and I say, yo, if I wanna listen to Ghostface, I listen to Ghostface. And then he say, nah, you wrong, you know, like it's, yeah, there is a similarity in the flow or the voice, you know, for sure. But definitely, you know, should, let's take another train also, you know, let's definitely take another train. Let's take the A train from Far Rockaway to here, the Heights, Washington Heights. 207th Street. Yeah, there's a lot of blah blah, you know, but sometimes the blah blah is also, maybe there is something in it, you know. It's good to communicate and it's not really a communication, it was more sort of a monologue. But yeah, that's definitely how I feel, you know, about how I discover art, and definitely, you know, how I discovered Pat's Day, and Pat Stay, rest in peace. You know, that's how I feel. And the whole story, yeah, was like, came from, you know, a place of sometimes humbleness where you can also accept that you didn't see it right away, you know, and that this guy was like one of the greatest, you know, but I didn't see it right away, you know. But after his dope ass performances, I watched, like, you know, a lot of times, like, I watch a lot of battle rap also. I'm definitely like turntablism, scratching, you know, like all that I love, but battle rap, I don't know, you know, it's like a cappella battle rap is something special, you know. Maybe because I'm from the battle scene, also the DMCs, the Supremacy, the TKO, all the, like, I came also from this battle DJ aspect, you know, so maybe watching all these rappers gives me power in my world too, as a DJ who, like, I think I stopped battling since 10 years right now already, but maybe not really, you know, maybe not really, and maybe there is some big battles coming, and I'm definitely always ready and hungry for that shit, because it pushed me to another level, you know. And so battle rap, a cappella battle rap, the URL, or like Diltily in Germany, back in the days, Rap Contenders in France, but it's a little bit, I don't see them that active right now. I might be wrong, you know, and there might be like an underground scene, but for now I don't see France strong in the a cappella rap game. But definitely like the US, Canada, like with KOTD, and Germany, yo, it's crazy. It's definitely crazy. That's the A-Train, Puma, baby. That is the A-Train, and we go on from Far Rock Away, you know, like kind of Brooklyn, Queens. It's Brooklyn, but you're not far from Queens, kind of. And we go into 207th Street, which you should know also, you know. I think you're also a Jersey girl, you know, so you should know 175th George Washington Bridge. We definitely gonna pass that station. Yeah, let's maybe listen to a round of Pat Stay, you know. I don't know, I'm gonna just like try to find like a random round on UA2. I say UA2 because of Roy Nock, you know, who it's such a private joke, you know, such a private joke. Only 5 people and myself can understand that, but whatever, you know. Shout out to Roy Nock, who gave us a lot of freedom. You a city girl too, yeah, you're definitely a NYC girl too. DJ Puma, baby, yeah, played a lot in NYC. That's why I met, by the way, DJ Puma, baby, also in New York City clubs. I think we can say that, right, Puma?
That's a win.
Okay, so I picked the battle versus Shotgun, where he wear the flower dress. Yo, don't get me wrong, Shotgun did also his thing, but that's Shotgun Shook.
Red dot, the mag beam. Think too long, fool? Cause we already knew Patrick was some cross-dressing drag queen. Yeah, spirits flying through the crib when I'm raising with the clip. Headshot, Patrick could be a ghost making vases with his bitch.
Of course, it's very aggressive, you know? And there's a lot of bad words in it, so, you know? But the energy is crazy.
Hey, sir, stick clips, 4-5 on a big white boy, Rick Smith. Hit P-A-T and get extra points.
You see, so the other guy is not a rookie.
40 cal.
Definitely, yo, we gonna
random, put his back on the griddle. Take his ribs, V12 sliding with his racks in the middle. Give a fuck.
In the future, there's gonna be maybe some shows also where we're gonna watch some rap battles together, you know. But just to give a shout out, like, and rest in peace to Pat Stay today. You know, we play a little bit of Pat Stay.
Get water damage. I run a tight ship. Liar, please. The vice grips. Who the leader? 15 shots. I'm packing the chrome. I hit the chief with a bullet. Patrick Mahomes.
Shotgun from Jersey.
Round one.
Hey, y'all hear me?
Okay, now that's Pat Stay. Pat Stay,
hey,
rest in peace.
Up?
Let's go.
URL, glad to be back. It's Pat, your favorite rapper from Smack. This guy tried dressed like me. Pretty smooth, though. You got suited too, bro? Look at you go. Hey! Kept talking about me smoking crack. So, look at me and look at you. If I smoke crack, that may be something you need to look into. I'm the best. I just killed. Yo. I just killed Rock and you gave me him? That shit ain't making sense. Yo, I killed Verb too. Bitch, I'm the fucking main event. He hanging with Twerk, who's a blood,
Pat,
and this sucker's claiming
peace.
Crip. Shit, all you need's a white boy. We can be the new color-changing clique.
You see, that's the energy I'm talking about, you know? The battle rap scene is crazy, the reactions, you know? The reactions are just crazy in battle rap, and I love this energy. For me, that's like the essence of hip-hop, you know? Like this, oh shit, this thing is very childish also sometimes, you know, but there is some beauty to it, like, you know.
Hold on, hey, yo!
You see, he cannot even rap so that the crowd goes crazy, you know.
See, you wild, but I got more style than you. all sauce like Italian food. You wanna tap my pockets? Go ahead, I allow you to. But try to dunk on me, bitch, I'll foul you. Better tone that shit down a few. You don't wanna get beat up by a white boy in a flower suit.
That's why he wear the flower suit, you know? You can watch this video, you know, on YouTube. It's Pat Stay versus Shotgun.
Up in my face,
Shotgun
up in
suit.
My face, but with Hitman, he was miles from dude. Gave him so much room, Mario got a power boost. Damn, that man punked you, made a fool of you, told you if you touch him during the battle, he would slump you. Said, I bet you won't. Right in your face 100 times, battled in Jersey, and the whole time, he didn't even brush you. Coward shit. Coward shit.
Some real talk also. Yo. That's what we love, I think, in battle rap,
yo.
Right?
Yo, where was all the pocket taps and dunk moves? You just choose people who most likely ain't gonna punch you. Well, fuck you. I ain't scared of you. Bump you, shove you, heart check, whatever the fuck I want to, snuff you, baby mom's youngest and oldest son too, I don't care if he's only 12, that little sucker will catch the 1-2.
Oh, shit. Ay, 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 ay.
Hold up.
Pat Stay, rest in peace.
Hold
yo.
Up.
He passed away 2 weeks ago. I didn't even,
Shotgun
you know,
Shug.
See the,
Hold
the news.
Up. Shotgun Shug. Knock on wood. He'll show up at your barbecue and them hot dogs good. Yo, hold up. While you was writing your little raps for me, Pat, making people laugh and shit, I was on the block, killing people, dodging bullets over a brick. What's your life like? Oh, shut it, Jimmy, would ya? Man, let me keep exposing this clown. You make at least 10 grand a battle. That's like 70 grand a year. Plus all the merch and music. Bro, fools would kill to have your career. If I was a dude on your block you'd be posted on, I'd find this shit weird. Like, well, you think this shit's cool or something? Bro, you're famous. Why are you here? What's your life like? What's your
Real
life like?
Talk.
Hold up. Hold
Real
up.
Talk.
What's your life like? Oh man, I can't. Oh,
it feels.
I can't imagine. Sounds awful, dude. Performing in front of hundreds of fans. Shaq always trying to talk to you. Got to go to all them meet and greets. Selling T-shirts and jogging suits. Getting $10,000 to rap for 9 minutes. I am so sorry, dude. Boy, you must be tired. A tiger leaping through hoops of fire. You survivor. I am so goddamn proud of you.
Oh, Pat Stay, rest in peace. Really sad.
Yo, that's the end of that shit.
Yeah, that's the end of that shit. And yeah, he was just like a super dope battle rapper. And he was stabbed like in a club, you know, super surprising this news to me, you know, like but it reminds us that it can always happen and that, you know, yeah, shit like that happens, you know. Pat Stay, rest in peace. Condolences go out to the family, to the friends, to the fans, you know, and yeah, to the battle rap scene, definitely. So rest in peace, Pat Stay.
Bye. That's real.
Practice time on some tasers on that side. I do the tasers on this side here. Still have to get them cleaner, but on that side I'm struggling with the tasers, so I have to get it in, you know. So the tasers. Click flare. Tasers. Exactly, M. Kurt. We cut it up on Koopsa.
Keep it real.
it real.
JFK, the airport, everybody who wants to take a plane and leave New York or come from somewhere else have to very often pass here, you know, Howard Beach, John F. Kennedy, JFK, the airport, we here. I hope you guys enjoy the ride and yeah, let's go, let's continue riding. We stream for 2 hours and 3 minutes right now, let's continue a little bit. And get these tasers in. Let's go. Get a scratch in fast and you don't even have it down slow, you know? That means you have to practice slow, understand the whole mechanic of that. Don't forget to breathe also. Let's go.
Keep it real.
Keep it real.
Okay.
Try to fuck it up, you know? We try to funk it up. That's what we're trying. On that side, yes. On the other side, nah, not sure, you know? Have to... You see, the muscle is tired now.
Okay, okay.
Yes, I think 24 hours we could do that. We could do like a scratch marathon. And scratch for 24 hours. I'm not sure if that's a good idea. Because I would be dumb enough to do some shit like that. But definitely with like some drinking and toilet pause. Yeah, toilet is very important. Toilet is very important, you know. Don't hold it in for 24 hours just because you scratch on Twitch. Don't do that. By the way, I feel Twitch, you know. Twitch is really like a platform I have fun with, you know. It's pretty cool to be here with you guys, you know. And try to achieve greatness. I don't know if we try to achieve greatness, but we try to achieve something. How you like the ride through New York City? Through Brooklyn. Let's say Brooklyn, then we were in Queens. Focus on the tasers.
Bye.
a real satisfying technique, you know. When you're able to loop the taser, it feels really good, you know. It comes from a laser, just like pushing the record forward and backward, but then you have like this kind of maîtrise, I don't know how to say that in English, this kind of preciseness, you know, of the two-click flare. And that gives a pretty cool flow, like like it's like more like, you know, like I don't know how you say aspirer. Hey, even last time I looked for this effing word, you know, and I still don't know it. Aspirer, how you say aspirer in English? You see, I can say it in French, aspirer. In German, aufgesogt, sogt, saugt. Nah, I think I only can say it in French. Grand Street, let's go. Serato right now. I would have done that with a real vinyl. The needle would have jumped like I'm very lucky that I'm on Serato right now, because I feel this Serato record is a little bit crooked, you know, so sometimes when I hit the vinyl, the needle is jumping, you know. People who use phase would now say, yo Nelson, get a phase. You see how how that sounded like old school reggae? Sometimes that's my soul also, you know? Old school Nelson. Let's go. Merci, merci. Ça a toujours besoin encore d'un peu plus d'entraînement. It still needs a little bit more practice, you know, to be clean, clean as a mother. I don't know why I make these noises sometimes with my mouth, but you know, it is what it is. Let's go.
Call.
working on the tasers. The tasers, tasers, tasers. It's not some lasers, but it's the taser. So, yeah, it's really a laser.
Keep it real.
Yeah, the needle is jumping as the motherfucker. That's some lasers, okay? It's like pretty much throwing the record back and forth. That's also a little bit too loud, you know, like for purposes of showing it to you. The cut is, might be a little bit loud, you know, but usually the lasers, you have them maybe here. You see, because it's a very high note you create with that, it's good like to not be too much in the ears, you know, like of your audience, even if that's exactly what I just did. But to show you guys, you know, that you hear that a little bit more precisely. By the way, I hope you hear the mic precisely also. And yeah, I feel that's better. I feel that's better, 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 better. DJ Puma baby have the right emotes. DJ M Cut also appreciate you guys. Thank you so much. So good. I think this cut feels so good because there is this back throw, you know, like which, and this kind of looping of the whole technique, which makes it very, very satisfying, you know, to cut it up on the taser, or to cut it up with the taser technique. Let's say it like this. Minutes, 10, 15 minutes on one technique, that's really how you progress also, you know. Comme je disais, si tu restes 10 minutes, 15 minutes sur la même technique, ça t'aide beaucoup à progresser. I say it for DJ M-Cut, who might not understand everything in English, so and for all the other French people who might watch the show, or maybe not, because French Nelson is talking in English. So, we don't watch that shit until he speaks in French. I don't care. I'm definitely gonna continue speaking English to, like I said in the other shows, also connect everybody, you know? And sometimes I translate it in French or in German, but I would love to keep it like in English, that we can connect as much people as we can, you know? So, that's what we should do, definitely. Yeah, that was the show for today. I hope you enjoyed, and that was coming from the dentist Nelson, you know, so definitely we ride. We're gonna make like maybe one more station and then we out of here. And I hope you guys appreciate the show. Chili, you are welcome. Metronels, like a metronome. Like a metronome, but a metronels. I love that shit. Metronels. Yo, next time I come with the Schaffner cap, you know? Yo, we speak French, English, German. What the fuck? I hope you guys still understand the show. Is there a show? Or is the show? Or okay, shut up. Today, appreciate really each one of you. Thank you so much thank you, Cultura Lima. The teeth, you know, the fucking teeth is very important. Take care of your health. That's if you can, you know, if you don't have to sell your house to get two teeth repaired. Welcome to the US, I guess. But yeah, shout out to you. Thanks, Cultura Lima. Thanks, M. Kurt. Thanks, Puma Baby. Yeah, thank you. Thank you, everybody who was like connected today. Eisenman. Appreciate you guys. Thanks for your time. That's why I thank you guys, you know, for your time, for your good energy, for this good vibes, you know, for the emotes in the chat. And yeah, see you guys next week, all right, or on the weekend. Have a great week. Here in New York is like 140 heads of state who meeting this week here in New York, so I try to not go out for this week. New York is a little crazy right now, but you're welcome, Cultura Lima. You're welcome. De rien, M-Cut, avec plaisir. So, who we can raid, I don't know. I have to follow more people that I can raid more people. Sometimes when I want to raid more people, there's no DJs online, like, which I can like raid. So I'm trying, you know, I'm really trying to. Yeah, the raid gonna be for next time. Wish you guys a great rest of your week, right? And see you guys on the weekend, Saturday. We here at Nelson Scratch TV. I'm out. Let's stop the train in this station, and then we definitely gonna come back with the A train. Maybe next time we do from 207 to Brooklyn. Let's see. All right, guys. Thank you so much. See you next time. Peace.